a hard-fought game in the state of Florida against what I consider an NCAA tournament team in Florida State. We had our chances. I didn't think we executed as good as we've had. We have in the past. Down the stretch, a couple of plays that were a little uncharacteristic, but really the credit goes to Florida State. I thought they played a physical, tough, hard-nosed game against us. I don't think it was an offensive display either way, but I thought both teams played really good defense. And, it was a great three-point shooting contest for both teams. And, we're 10-1. We're going to go home for Christmas, and we'll spend some time with our families to come back and try to restart another run. Hopefully, our guys are ready to recommit to what we're doing.
Coach, obviously, you guys didn't shoot well, but what effect did they have? They had 12 blocks, and they fell at 7. What effect did that have on your shooting?
Probably a little. I would say quite a bit. I mean, they were big and long, and they guarded the paint. They did a nice job of guarding the paint. To beat them, you're going to have to make some threes. They were 7-3 and 7-1 in the paint with the other guys 6-9 in athletic. And I thought they blocked a lot of shots, and that affected us. One of our rules of thumb going into the game was don't let them block shots. Don't let them have more than 2 or 3 blocks. 12, you can probably pinpoint that as the difference in the game.
Can you tell from warm-ups that they're going to be suffering from the
shootout? Some guys were going to shoot there this morning. They told us that they were going to have some issues. So
Does that get in your head a little bit after a while that when nobody's getting rolls, and does that mess with people's psyche a little bit?
I don't really think so. I feel like you stay aggressive all the time trying to attack on the state shooting, so I don't think that'd be effective that much.
Derek, what was your thought process when you saw the final position play out in the last few days?
We got a great look. I mean, we just got to put that one in. I thought it was all a foot from the basket. That was a great look. Just got to make that. Are you asking me if I think you got hit?
No, showed some emotion on the sideline.
Listen, I'm not. Those guys are great refs, man. They do a great job of not being confused on one play. It was a physical game all the way through. And so, yeah, he got hit. Potentially, he's got to put that one in.
Did you take a timeout instead of a...
Yeah, I did. I always play the game over my mind quite frequently of what I would do the same differently. Thus far this year, knowing my philosophy, we've done pretty well, so I stuck with it. Now maybe I'll reevaluate. When they went the zone the one time, that's the one I would probably potentially call a timeout again, maybe put another shooter in. That was my thing through the chat to Cady on a tough play, so that would be something that we'll probably talk about as a staff.
On the last one, when you went to Cady inside, was that you would want to, or did you count three at that one?
Yeah, absolutely. I think we had enough time. I thought to maybe get a steal or call a timeout put them in the free throw line and then set up a long ball play to get half court. So we had enough timeouts and they were, the game was moving, so it was kind of like, all right, if we get a two, we'll take it. If a three was up, we were going to take it also.
How do you expect the two teams to find a lot of 40 points a game and all of a sudden when the scoreboard 50 something?
I think that was a little bit more them than us. They wanted to play a little more than half over their size. At least that was my impression where we're not. The game actually played in our favor because of their size. I didn't think the big 7-footers could run with us. So when we got into the half court and they let the game be a little more physical than usual, I think that helped them. Yeah, absolutely. You saw there was a 7-minute window in there in the second half of the game. Was our flow, our flavor. And we pulled away, but we never took full advantage. And I think we got up 3, maybe 5, or something like that. But in a normal case, we could get it to 7 or 9. We just had to make plays. We couldn't miss layups, missed open shots, free throws. The whole ball of whack and hold it to one.
Chad, did you take a game like this? Guys in the group just kind of shake it off and go forward. A good team and just kind of go forward and keep the momentum going.
I think it's the team that is what helps us right now. You know how it feels, it's a funny game now, so I think it's the team that, think about that break out of the motivation.
Depending on the brand, this name is done like Cady Lalanne or somebody.
I thought it was
Thank you.
point of separation between Florida State and us, to be honest with you. They're a really good team, and they're going to get better. I'm not sure if I've seen a team shoot one for 15 for three and win a game, though. I'm not sure if that's possible, and then miss 10 free throws. So, the other stuff I thought we did well. I mean, we defended them, turned them over. We did some good stuff, but we just didn't put together a whole game. So.
Derek, you guys have won a lot of games so far. Have you given any thought to how the team would respond to a loss, even when you talked about the returning
run? No, I haven't. I was anticipating we'd win as many as we could, and then we'd deal with it at that point, honestly. So these guys are good kids. I mean, they're disappointed. They're going to take their lunch, then they're going to go home and have something to eat for the holidays, and they'll be back ready to go. I mean, I'm probably the one that'll be pulled up in the corner for four straight days, so I have to apologize to my wife for prematurely.
Is there something to take for the fact that it's not like the teams that you can play against going forward can all of a sudden add that much size to their roster that the blueprint that worked for Florida State today isn't necessarily something that you
can I mean, there were 12 blocks, and I just off the top of my head, I remember the 14 or 16 layups that we missed. It was attributed to their size, so, I mean, that's really like 40 points, that obviously that's not going to happen, but I thought their size and their rim protection attributed to probably 16 to 18 points that we normally would finish. And then those 7-footers kind of moved too. It wasn't just them though. The kid Gilchrist is 6'9", the Carl White 6'7", 6'8", and then the 2 guard is 6'7". So you go in there, and there's a lot of length and size. So if somebody can quickly put together a team that has that length and size, I'd be happy.
Hey, should this team be ranked up a little bit?
Oh, I don't know. I'm sure. We'll have to see how these other opponents' games play out against them. Our RPI is pretty good.
I don't know.
We'll have to get you one then.